Hello and welcome. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how you can create a dynamic chart. So you can see I have two forms, a login form and a company projects form. So I'm going to open up the login form. It's asking me to select the project manager. So I'm going to select Howard Jenkins and press the login button. And in the company projects form, it shows the projects that Howard Jenkins has. He's at 15% for the creating a workflow for human resources and 40% for creating an accounting database. I'll press the back to login button. And let me go to Roger Sanders, press login. And he's at 25% for creating a company website and 75% for creating a company logo. This chart is the same. It's a dynamic chart. So in this lesson, I'm going to show you how you can create this dynamic chart. Okay, so I have two tables, a table called TBL Project. This contains three columns, a project manager, project, and completion with the percentages for each project. Then I have another table called TBL Project Manager that just has the two names for the project manager. So the first thing I want to do is create a query. So I'm going to create query, query design. I'm going to drag in the TBL underscore project table, highlight all three fields, and put them down below here. Let me expand out the columns. So, in our criteria for project manager, we're going to refer to a form, which we're going to create in a second here. I'm going to zoom in to show you. So in the project manager criteria, it's going to look for a project manager combo box on the login form, which we're going to create. So let me save this query. I'm going to call it Query Project Manager. Hit OK. Close it. Next thing I want to do is create a form. So go to Create Form Design. This is going to be the form that has our chart. So I'm going to go to Form Design, click the arrow, Chart. Let's drag a chart right here. So I'm going to use the query that we just created, Project Manager. Next, I'm going to select the project and the completion fields. Next, so we have project as our x-axis, series as a y. That's good. Next, we don't need a legend. I'm going to call this title of the chart, Company Projects. Hit finish. Let's make this chart a little bigger. Let me double click in the chart so I can change some of the properties. So I want the bars of the chart to be a different color. So I'm going to select it. Let's choose orange. Let's make the title bigger. And we want a series. So data labels value. Okay. And we could just click anywhere outside of the chart to go back to where you were. Now we need a text box that shows the name of our project manager. So I'm gonna click text box, put it right above the chart. I'm gonna call this text box. See, project manager text box. Project manager, I misspelled it. Project manager text box right here. Let's change the size, the font. So let's say 18 and center it. That looks good. Let's change the background of the form. Let's just choose purple. And we need one more object added to our form. Let's go back to form design. We need a button. So I'm gonna call this back to login. Select the button. Call this button name BTN underscore login. BTN underscore login. Go to the event tab, on click, code builder. Before we do that, I'm going to save our form. Right click here, save. Call our form, form underscore company projects. Now I'm going to select our button, go back to on click. So when we press the back to login button, we want to close our existing form. So I'm gonna do a do command. Close form, comma. It's the name of our existing form. So it's gonna close our existing form and it will open up the login form. So another do command, open. And we haven't created our login form yet, but we're gonna call it form underscore login. All right, just gonna copy that name. Zoom in so you can see it. So we're gonna close our existing form and open the login form when we press the go to back login button. All right, save it, close out of this form. Now let's go to create form design. We're gonna create our login form. Let's change our background color, same color as our company projects form. I need to create a combo box. This combo box is gonna have a list of our project managers. We need to change the label, select the project manager. Change font inside of our combo box. Let's make this a little smaller. That's good. We still have our combo box selected. I'm gonna call this combo box project manager combo box. Oops. Project manager combo box. Okay. Select it again. Now we need to populate our combo box. Go to the event tab. Under row source, the drop down, we're going to choose our TBL project manager table. Remember, this is our list of our project managers. So when we do that, now we should have our project managers inside of our combo box. Preview it. We do. There they are. Now all we need to do is create a button that's going to take us to our company projects form. So create a button right underneath the combo box. We'll call this the label login. Rename the label or the button, btn_login for the name of the button. All right, so I still have the button selected. I'm going to the event tab, go to on click, go to code builder. And here, I'm going to use another do command. Open form, name of the form of the company projects form is called FRM_company_projects. We want a normal view of the form. Okay. Zoom in, show you that. I spelled it wrong. FRM_company_projects. Now we need to save this form. We said we're going to call this form FRM_login. Hit OK. We saved it. Let's test it. So select the project manager. I'm going to select Roger Sanders and press login. We go back. Howard Jenkins. We need to figure out why it didn't show our name here. Oh, I know. So I need to, on our company projects form, I'm going to click on in the corner of our form. This will get us to the properties of our form. And I'm going to go to the event tab. And I'm going to go to on open. Select code builder. So what was the name of this form or text box? Project manager text box. So let's go back. So me, which is the name of the form, that text box dot value is going to be equal to forms form login. And the combo box on the login form it was called Project Manager Combo Box, I believe. All right. Save that. So there we go. So we chose Howard Jenkins in our login form. It has who we select at the top here, and these are his projects. I'll go back to the login form. Let's choose Roger Sanders. Has Roger Sanders and his projects. Let me go change this chart. Click the chart, double click it. I'm gonna change the data series. Thought we changed this to make sure we show the value. We have the percentages. Now everything should be good. Let me change the colors again. Change it to orange. Save the changes. So we have Roger Sanders. Our chart is orange with the percentages. Go back to our login form. Howard Jenkins. See, dynamic chart. If you enjoyed the content of this video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. We'll see you next time.